picking up a tailwind on the bend, according to the Australian flag and the Italian flag, and then cross. Well, the flag's indicating there for quite a strong wind blowing now as we just sit on the top of this mountain and find the easiest way up, the contours, if we can follow them. Five riders left in the front group now.
Gosenhagen, he's really got to ride himself inside. He's not a great climb when it comes to the high mountains, so he will ride and set this tempo for as long as he can to help the team, because he knows that once he gets closer to the summit, he's going to have to pass over responsibility to Richie Porte and then to Michael Rogers. But they want to keep with Bradley Wiggins as many men as they can. And what about that for an unbelievable snaking peloton?
It's like you're in testing, doesn't it, as they start to zigzag their way around all those corners and just get up the side of this mountain. First time the Tour de France has ever climbed this mountain in the Jura. Always narrow roads, so you get some idea now as to why we tell you the descent is dangerous. We're going up the same side the riders went up in the recent Dauphiné, the French Gilbert race to the Tour. And then we come down the other side. There are actually six leaders left up there. Thomas Voigtler, Michele Scarponi, Jean-Christophe Perrault, Sandy Cassar, Luis Leon Sanchez, and Dries Deivens are the men up front.
Yeah, in fact, this climb fill was used in the 1988 Criterium du Dauphiné, and that was won by Charlie Motte at that time. But it has been used.